Can we now request Reverend Swami Sarvalokananda Ji Maharaj, Secretary of Ramakrishna Mission, Narendrapur, for his address?
Om Asatoma Sadgamaya Tamasoma Jyotirgamaya Mityorma Amritagamaya Om Shanti Shanti Shanti. O Lord, lead us from unreal to real. Lead us from darkness to light. Lead us from death to immortality. Om, peace, peace, peace. Galaxy of spiritual luminaries on the dais, of the dais, Dr. Karan Singhji sitting here, ladies and gentlemen present here. At the outset, I must thank the organizer for having invited me to this very important and relevant conclave. Since the dawn of civilization, spirituality has been the backbone, the basis and foundation of India. Without spirituality, we cannot think of the sustainable growth of the nation. Swami Vivekananda has rightly said that India will rise not with the power of matter, but India will rise with the power of spirit. It is quite true. That is why Swami Vivekananda said again that first deluge the land with the spirituality. If you want to do something for India. Dear friends, to become spiritual, it has become a fashion nowadays. Everybody wants to become spiritual, not only in India and outside India. But unfortunately, many of us do not know the meaning of spirituality. Actually, what does it mean? Spirituality doesn't mean just simply go to the temple, offer some flowers and sweets to the deity, and do some meditation in Japam, and come back from the temple. Spirituality has a wide meaning, very wide meaning. Swami Vivekananda has given us very briefly the definition of spirituality, real definition of spirituality. Swamiji said time and again, the spirituality means transformation of inner being. In other words, he has said that spirituality means be good and to do good. This is the real meaning of spirituality. You have to become transparent, unselfish. You have to become active, dynamic. You have to become patriot and to do good to others. Dr. Karan Singhji was quoting Swamiji's teaching, rather motto of Ramakrishna Mission, that do good to others. How we can do good to others? In this connection, I like to quote the letter written by Swami Vivekananda to Maharaj of Mysore. Beautiful letter, very touching letter. He's writing, my dear noble prince, life is short. Vanities of life are a transitor. They alone live who live for others. Rest are more dead than alive. What a wonderful statements about the unselfishness. Swami ji kya kehte hain? Swami ji kehte hain hamare jeevan jo hai ye do din ke liye hai. Aaj hai kal nahi bhi ho sakta hai. Jeevan ke jitna ahankare hain wo bhi do din ke liye hai. Name, fame, power, position, wealth. Agar jo kuch bhi hai bahut hi chhanabhangur hai, chhanik hai. If it is so, वही यथार्थ रूप से जीता है जो दूसरे के लिए जीता है और तो सब जीते हुए भी मुर्दे का समान है स्वामी विवेकानंद इज टेलिंग व्हाट अ वंडरफुल स्टेटमेंट डियर फ्रेंड्स द रियल रिसोर्स एंड वेल्थ इज नॉट नेचुरल वेल्थ एंड मिनरल वेल्थ और जीडीपी ग्रोथ द रियल Wealth and resource is human resource of any country, of any race. The human resource is the real resource of any country or any nation. So Swami Vivekananda said time and again that you have to develop that human resource. Then only you can build the nation. Also Swamiji has to put emphasis on this human resource. You have to divinizing and specializing this human resource. Then it can take the country forward and forward. Dear friends, we want to build another nation, but at the same time, you have to build our character. It is very important. Whatever untoward incidents happening all over the world, it is due to crisis of character. We are passing through the crisis of character. Unfortunately, we do not have individual character, the social character, national, international character. That is why all sorts of untoward things happening all over the world. You know very well, you read newspaper, watch TV, you know the whole world is just burning. Whole world is full of violence. Why? Because we don't have character. That is why Swami Vivekananda used to say, the power of the character is such that it can clip through the adamantine wall of all difficulties. Dear friends, with the strength of character, you can solve any problem, you can meet any challenge in your life, there is no doubt about it. Whether it's individual challenge or challenge of the nation. Dear friends, that is why Swami Vivekananda is to put on more emphasis on the strength of character. I'd like to tell you the wonderful incident happened in the life of Swami Vivekananda. All of you know that Swami Vivekananda went to America to address the Parliament of Religions. And after giving lecture in the first session of the Parliament of Religions, he became a world hero. Overnight, he became a world hero. And after that, he stayed nearly 5 years in Europe, American Europe. When he was in Europe, he was walking on the street of London, putting dress like this, ochre robe, ochre turban on his head, and some Britishers were watching him from the distance, and Britishers were just talking with each other, the what type of man he is. He has put on a very peculiar dress. It is quite natural. Swami Vivekananda's scenario is not the scenario of today. Swami Vivekananda's scenario more than 100 years. In those days, the Britishers were not aware of this kind of peculiar dress. They were habituated to see a person in suited boot with a necktie. So out of curiosity, the Britishers went to Swami Vivekananda and asked him, Swamiji, asked him, from which country you are coming? Swamiji said, I am Indian, I have come from India. Swami Vivekananda always used to feel pride of India. So Swamiji said, I am Indian, I have come from India. Oh, you have come from India. Then your country must be uncivilized. Your country is illiterate. But Swamiji said, why my country will be uncivilized? Swamiji said, when they said these Britishers, the Britisher says that you have put on peculiar dress. After hearing this, Swami Vivekananda gave very befitting reply to the Britishers. He said, look, in your Western culture, Western tradition, and Western civilization makes a man, this tailor and grace make a man great and civilized. But in my country, in my civilization, in my culture, tailor and dress do not make a person great and civilized. In my country, in my civilization, character makes a man great and civilized, Swami Vivekananda said. Dear friends, so you have to build character if you want to build nation. Not only that, Swami Vivekananda said, what should be our national ideal? National ideals, he said, that renunciation and service are the twin ideal of our nation, because Swamiji believed, strongly believed, that this, without this twin ideal, we cannot make India great and vibrant. Swamiji made prophecy that India will become the Vishwa Guru, India will become world teacher. Dear friends, today or tomorrow, after 10 years or 20 years, definitely India will rise and India will become strong and vibrant, because Swamiji's prophecy cannot go in vain. Because Swamiji was not ordinary human being, he was a rishi. And in Sanskrit called rishi vakya, is apta vakya. His words cannot go in vain, but India will rise. There is no doubt about it. But as I said before, the India will rise with the power of spirit, with the power of spirituality. There is no doubt about it. Dear friends, we have to become spiritual and we have to build our nation. Time is over. I'll just finish. Don't mind. I just wrap up with a famous Vedic prayer, that is Sarve Bhavantu Sukhina, Sarve Santu Niramaya. Let all be happy, let all be healthy. Namaskar, Dhanyavad.
We thank Swamiji.